If...
Right.
Phil? Better? James? G'day.
Peter, good to meet you.
Andrew.
Peter.
Take a seat. Clean up, put on my
best shirt. Losing Steve made me realise that, you know what, the most important thing about this band is the friendship. And it's made us all become, I think, closer friends and because of the loss of one of our dearest friends, you know?
And it's all for you. All for you.
In January, Cold Chisel lost its heartbeat. Its drummer, Steve Prestwich. He'd been with the band since the very beginning, 1973.
Literally sort of living together, travelling together. You know the old saying, you know, your friends are the people who you know all their faults as well, but you still like them. You know, I think that's what it boils down to.
For me, personally, you know, I realised that, you know, part of, you know, the thing that made Cold Chisel a great rock and roll band was the fact that we were mates.
What did Cold Chisel deliver that gives you such longevity?
And the thing that made Cold Chisel the band that it was, you know, people think, you know, like it takes all this chemistry and getting on to make a band. It also takes tension. Tension within the band made the band on the edge all the time. People would come and see this band because they thought it was going to implode at any minute, you know, and it very well could have, you know, because there was five people who all had definite ideas what they wanted for a band, and they all fought, you know, tenaciously to get to it. You know, I was just the loudest.
And the most drunken.
And the most drunken, and probably the most dangerous because of that.
Would it be fair to say the wildest time was the Countdown Awards in 1980?
No, that was actually pretty contrived. We were much wilder than that. Yeah.
The wildest and most publicised fights were between Jimmy and drummer Steve.
Steve would come up and just tell you exactly what was on his mind, especially if he had a drink.
Yeah.
And unfortunately, he would always tell me what was on his mind when I'd had a drink. And so, you know, we'd end up sort of belting each other. I remember a couple of times Phil pulling us apart. And Phil's, he's a gentle soul, you know? And Phil would be in there going, you know, cut it out or I'm going to have a go at you. And the two of us would look up and laugh at him, you know, and then go back at it again. But, you know, I mean, there was a lot made out of that stuff. The people thought it was, it was anger in the back. But it was actually just taking it. It was like brothers, you know? We share some
history. Why did we split?
Yeah, why did you split the first time?
Oh, I think we couldn't stand the sight of each other, man.
The first Cold Chisel breakup was in the early 80s. In 1998, they reunited and broke up again. Over the next decade, the band would try to patch things up, but could never make it work for longer than a few concerts. In the 21st century, you blokes are rock and roll's answer to Dame Nellie Melba. Break up, they're back.
Yeah,
break
absolutely.
Up, they're back.
They're back. No. That's John Farnham. No. You know what? You know, with Cold Chisel, you know, we just decided that we'd learnt enough from each other at the time and had to split up. You know, it was, I always sort of had a bit of a gut feeling that, you know, we still had sort of unfinished business. And it's one of those bands where we cannot be together for 20 years and get in a rehearsal room and the first day, you strap on guitars and get up there, the first, you know, few bars, no matter what you're playing, it could be, you know, Wild Thing or, you know, anything. It immediately sounds like Cold Chisel.
The fire was rekindled in 2009 at a reunion concert. I'm shipping steel, shipping steel. It all went so well that the five mates agreed the time was right to become Cold Chisel once more.
We are such a charge out of the way we played together. Let's do some writing, you know? Let's have some fun.
And was the magic there again?
Whenever the playing happens, the magic seems to just start up again.
And yet, Steve fell ill during this get-together. Mm-hmm. Can you tell us about that?
Well, for me, it was just completely unexpected, I think, because Steve had been having symptoms and troubles for a couple of years, but I only heard about it a week or so before.
Less than 2 weeks after being diagnosed with a brain tumour, Steve died. He was 56.
I don't know why, but the night before he died, when he was in the hospital, I got on, you know, and Steve and I, you know, we mates, like I said, but we didn't sort of phone and talk all that much. I just got a feeling and I texted him. I said, "Steve, I want you to know I'm a better man for knowing you and I love you." And he wrote back, "I love you too." And that was the last things that we wrote to each other. And then the next morning, I think Ian rang me.
Yeah, Ian rang me.
Ian Moss, yeah.
And said
that he's dead, we're going to have to turn the machines off.
Oh.
And, you know, it was a real, you know, such a blow.
When he died, was there some sense, well, that's the end of the band?
Yeah, yeah, there's thoughts there. yeah, that kind of thing. Wondering if we could keep going and still be the same, still be as good.
What made you decide to keep going with it? Ian?
I think just the love of music, just really, yeah, bottom line, just want to keep playing. I didn't want anything to stop that.
At a photo shoot, a recreation of the Breakfast at Sweethearts album cover from 1979. This was the band back then, and here's Cold Chisel today. An empty chair was left for Steve.
Really good guys.
No.
Perfect.
We've all sort of, you know, done major things and had major sort of, you know, upheavals and great things happen in our lives, you know, since.
We didn't know the kids then.
Right.
Yeah, that's right. Well, you didn't.
Now Chisel is carving out a new era with its biggest concert tour in 30 years. You can hear Steve still drumming on the new single, All For You.
And I'm young again, and it feels so good to be alive.
It was recorded before he died. This is the first Cold Chisel single in 13 years.
Will there be, without being morbid about it, will you feel his presence on stage when you play?
I hope so. Steve's going to be on stage with us all the time, and I'll probably still pick fights with him after a few drinks.
Some shadow boxing?
From spirits to spirit.
All for you. It's all.
Love it. Have I got it? You want to sign me up? Thank you. Thank you all. Thank you all.
And Jimmy Barnes has asked us to pass on a personal message to his fans. He wants you to know he's resting and that reports of heart problems were untrue. He'll be back behind the mic in no time, and of course we wish him all the best.